Hello, it's Keith here, and today we're going to be looking at how to do simple graphics on the VIC-20 as part of what I know as the simple series. Now in this series we create a single file, a single assembly file, and we learn how to make a very simple example. So we're going to be creating some bitmap graphics on the screen. Now I did bitmap graphics in quotes there because they're actually character blocks. We're going to define some custom characters and show them to the screen because that's about all we can do for the VIC-20 to get graphics on the screen. So anyway, let's go over to the source code and see today's example in action. So let's just fire it up here. Let's look at VIC-20 from the list here. And you can see there we've got a little smiley face there. So that's what we've just drawn. You can see there's some corruption on the screen because I didn't clear the screen from the previous boot up. Anyway, that's the first example we're going to do, but that's hardly overwhelming. Now, that's a single character block, but if we want to create a larger graphic, what we could do is define consecutive character blocks and then show them all on the screen in a grid. And that's what I've done just here. And we've got our Chibico mascot, the little vampire character, on the screen just here. And we're going to learn how to do that as well. But the starting position for that is just going to be this simple example here. Now in all my examples, I always use some zero page entries, a bit like Z80 registers. So I'm defining a HL pair here for our source data, BC for byte count, and DE for destination just here. We've got the start of our code here. If you don't know how to start a VIC-20 program or compile one, please see the Hello World series, which I covered that, because I'm assuming you're gonna know the basics of getting a program running today. Now the first thing we want to do is turn our screen on, and we're gonna need to set some parameters to do that. Going to have a look at those in just a moment, but we basically transfer them all to the memory addresses offset 9000 onwards, and we'll just have a look at those now. So here's the settings we're using today. I'm not going to go over them in detail. You can see a brief description of them here. We're effectively having to just set the defaults for the screen and also set the size of the screen and also set the character memory, and that's important for today because we're going to have to set that character memory so that we can use our custom characters, and that's what we're using to create our smiley and our Chibico because there is no bitmap screen on the VIC-20. Right, and what we're doing next is we're going to define our characters. Now I'm referring to it as defined tiles here, and the reason for that is I'm used to working with tile sprite systems like the NES, and so I kind of think of the character blocks as being tiles because they kind of are, at least by my way of thinking. So our source data is in the HL pair, our length is in BC, and our destination at memory address 1C00, which is where we're defining our custom characters, is in DE. And then we're using a function called define tiles, and we'll see that in just a moment. So where is our bitmap? Well, here it is. It's just this little smiley face here. Now, I don't know if you can see it, if you sort of stand away from your screen. Basically, these ones make a circle here. So that's the smiley face. These zeros here are the eyes, and then these zeros here are the smile. So that's our smiley face. And so each one or zero here is a pixel. And so that's our 8x8 tile that we're using today. Now, when it comes to defining the tiles, it's this function doing the work, this define tiles function, and this is transferring the data into the characters. To be honest, it's not hard, it's just memory, and all we do is we write the consecutive bytes into that memory, and then they become the tiles. So effectively, all we've got here is a sort of LDIR type command that is just transferring data from HL to DE, and doing so until BC becomes zero. So we've just got a loop here. Now, you can see here we're using Y as an offset, and then once Y reaches zero, we're just increasing the top byte of H and D to offset to the next 256 bytes and carrying on as required. Now, of course, our simple example won't really need that, but the next one might. So that defines our tile. The next thing we want to do is calculate the position in memory of one of the characters of the screen. And we're using a function called getVDPScreenPos, which again, doesn't make sense because it's not a VDP, but I use a common name for all of my functions within these tutorials because otherwise covering 25 systems like I do now in the tutorials, I'd be going completely mad if I was giving them all different names, and I'm pretty crazy already. So we'll try and make things a little bit easier. And so please excuse the ambiguous name of getVDPScreenPos here. So when it comes to calculating the memory address of a character on the screen, we need to understand the screen itself. The screen base, the start of screen memory, is 1E00, so we've set it up. If you set up different screen register settings, it might be different, but it's 1E00 for us. And then the width of the screen is 22 characters. So what we want to do is we want to take the Y position times 22 plus the X position plus 1E00, and that's what we're doing here. Now, usually in these tutorials, I use some kind of bit shifting to calculate the offset of the Y position. So I'd bit shift the Y value to get the calculation, but 22 doesn't work very well. And because the screen is so small, I'm just doing a simple loop here. So I'm taking the Y position and I'm just decreasing Y, adding 22 each time to HL, and that will effectively multiply Y by 22 here. We're adding the X position and we're adding 1E to the top byte because 1E00 is the base. So that will calculate the position of the character that we want to show on the screen. Now, as an added bonus, we also need to set the color. Now the color base is 9600 and the size is exactly the same. So what we can do is once we've used this function, we can add 7800 or just 78 to H, and that will calculate the equivalent character within the color information. And we're going to be doing that just here. So we're getting our VDP3 screen pos here from an X and Y coordinate here. And then what we're doing is we're selecting the tile. Now, because of the way the character map has been reconfigured, character 0 is now actually the first of our custom characters. And so what we're doing here is we're selecting character 0, which is our smiley tile. And then we're storing that in the calculated HL returned by getVDP screen pos here. We're then calculating the offset to color memory, adding hexadecimal 78 here to the H component. And this will calculate the same offset from 9600, which is the start of the color information. And we're setting our smiley, setting our smiley to color 4 here, which is what we're going to use for this example. And that will create our purple smiley, as you saw before. Now, what about the Chibico character? Well, the Chibico character is kind of similar. Rather than the bitmap being directly in the code here, I've used an ink bin. I created the file with Aku Sprite Editor, which is my free open source sprite editor. You can see it here. If we just go here and we select a two color mode spectrum, you can see we can convert color information. And if we go to 6502, VIC-20, save raw bitmap, that will export in the format used today, because this is what I used to make today's tutorial. Now, what it effectively does is it takes this and it will split it up into 8x8 character blocks. So this would be the first character, this would be second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and then this would be seventh here. And so it's breaking up this 48x48 bitmap into 8x8 squares, exporting all those in consecutive order, correct at least for this tutorial. Now, the start of the code is exactly the same as before, turning on our screen, transferring our bitmap data, which will be much bigger now, into the character data definitions, defining those custom characters. And then we're going to set all of those characters using this function fill area with tiles. So we're selecting a start X and Y in B and C here, a color in D. We're going to set the entire character to 4. Now, of course, we could, if we wanted, set different parts to different colors. But for this simple example, we're not going to do that. And we're just defining the width and height in tiles here, and the starting tile number, which is tile number 0 as before. Okay, let's have a look at fill area with tiles. So what are we going to do? Well, what we're going to do is we're going to calculate the position of the start of the line, fill consecutive tile numbers to it, and then we're going to retake that position, move it down a line, and carry on from the tile number that we ended here, and that will effectively fill the screen. So that's what we'll be doing now. So we're calculating our starting screen position just here, and then we've got our loop, and we're going to basically take our tile number, and we're going to transfer that tile number into the video memory as calculated by getVDP screen position. Then what we're going to do is we're going to set the color for that position. So we're just backing up ZH here and restoring it here, adding hexadecimal 78, because as I said before, 7800 is the offset of the color information from the character selection information within video memory. So we're now setting the color. We load in the color from D. If you remember, we set the color just up here, and that is just being stored there. Then we're restoring H and L because we don't want that offset anymore. We're increasing in Y here. And then what we're doing is we're increasing our tile number just here, and we are repeating until we've done the entire line. Once we have done the entire line, we're storing the new tile number back into ZE here. We're then increasing our Y position, and then we're calculating the next line down by adding hexadecimal 22 to HL. We're doing the L part here, and then any carry is being added to the H part here, and that will effectively move us down the line, and we're ready to repeat for the next line. Now, of course, we can just make some small changes to this if we want to play around. For example, if I change the color from 4 to 3, Well, now Chibico is feeling distinctly blue, so we can easily change the color there. And if I change the height to 3 here, well, Chibico is now half the height, and you can notice that the color information has not been changed for the lower part. So that's working all fine. So there you go. There's some simple examples of how we can define custom characters and use them as graphics. Now, if you want to play around with this, I'd suggest you go to my website and download the source code for today's example. Also, you can download the development tools and the crispwhite editors included in the source code file. And of course, if you want to see more of the VIC-20, I've got a variety of tutorials already covering this system in a various ways, including bitmap graphics I've covered before in this way. So please have a look at the VIC-20 playlist on my YouTube channel, or go to my website and have a look at it on there. We're going to be extending this example in the future. We're going to add joystick control, and we're going to move that smiley around the screen. So please like and subscribe if you want to see that. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. I hope you found it interesting, and it will give you some inspiration to have a go programming the VIC-20. Whatever you do, though, if you want to do a different system, I've got Z80 and 68000 tutorials as well on a wide variety of systems. As I say, I'm covering over 25 now, and I'm still looking to take on more. So please have a look around, see if there's something else you would enjoy more. Whatever you do, though, I hope you'll give programming a go, and I hope you enjoy the VIC-20. Thanks for watching today, and goodbye.